Hello everyone, Ron here. Welcome to the Pool Student Channel and thank you very much for watching everyone. Hey, this is going to be a sequel from my last video where I had those two break and runs where I walked through the importance of a pre-shot routine. I'm only going to put three balls on the table and I wanted to add to this, and I actually had Jason Sanders, one of my subscribers, really good player, great insight into the game, great advice, and you know, he talked to me about making sure that we, even on the simplest of shots, that we do this. And let me show you. So we've got the three balls out there. We'll just set this up with a ball in hand situation. So even, I'm gonna give it a little tiny bit of a cut angle. Even though it's almost straight in, I wanna come in, I wanna look at that line, and then I wanna step behind it, and then come into the shot, and make that shot. I'm trying to get on the two, so you can see that I rolled ahead a little bit. I got a little bit short. I'd like to have been able to get right straight on. I could draw it back for the three in the side, but I'm okay. I can still do the same thing. I'm just gonna go ahead and draw it, probably pull it back over here. I'll have a nice easy shot. But once again, I look at the shot, I come into the line, I step around it, I'm feeling the shot. I feel exactly what I want to do. I'm going to commit. Don't want to be on the cushion. And that worked out real well. I actually cheated the pocket. That was another thing that Jason talked about. Rather than just putting it in the center, that ball would have, that cue ball would have ran more down here. So I actually cheated it. So it was a little more full of a hit. And it brought it over here. And I have a nice simple shot. Once again, I'm going to look at the line in the pocket as easy as it is. Sometimes we don't need to even aim because they're so simple. But in this case, I'm going to go ahead and just see the line. So in my mind, I can feel what that cut angle will be for that ghost ball. So I step back around. I know what it is. I'm going to just do a little tiny bit of a stop shot here. Try to let the cue ball kind of go mid-table, up-table a little bit. Not bad. Just wanted to avoid that scratch. Now I've added the four ball. I've let the balls just lay where they wanted to go when I threw them out there. The cue ball ended up right here. The one ball is up table quite a ways, and I got to get on the two. Now this portion of the exercise is for me to focus on my smoothness of my stroke, on my transition. Now I'm not going to draw this ball, this cue ball off the one, because that comes across the shot line, because I can see the two needs to go in that corner. So I have a perfect opportunity here to go three rails. Inside spin to go one, two, three, and flow this way into this two. And that's what I'm gonna do. So take a look at the shot. It's a distance shot, so I've gotta stroke it real well. It is about spin. Looking at the line, feeling the shot. Here we go. I'm gonna use just the rail to kind of bridge from. I don't feel I'm on it there. It was a little bit too far on the outside of the shot line. Now I feel good. Notice I'm spinning it there, coming off that cushion. Pretty nice shot. I got a little cut angle, which is okay. At this point, I can see where my cue ball is gonna go into here. And here, it looks like my three will be easy, just natural center cue ball, and I'll have a three ball that'll go right into the side pocket. Now the idea is that I just make sure I make that two. Looking at that shot line, here's my pre-shot routine again. Need to make a nice stroke, feeling the shot. Don't feel it there, I was off a little bit. Now I'm on it. Look at that, nice straight in. Now at this point, I'm a little bit funny. I would like to have been, an inch would have made a huge difference because I would have drew it right back over here against this cushion and have this four ball right there. So what I'm gonna have to do here is I can draw this back to here to have a long shot up in the corner. I have two options, or I can follow and then bring the cue ball across and back out. I'm gonna go ahead and follow so I don't have to hit the longer shot. So here's this one. I'm looking at the shot. I wanna get this speed judged. Not bad, not bad. Could have hit it a little bit firmer, a little more spin. Now I'm looking at the shot line. It's gonna go right in the corner. Let's see if we can put it in clean. I'm gonna use a little bit of low left here. That'll help throw the four ball into the corner. Perfect, didn't hit the cushion on the way in. The low left threw it in there, gave it pure roll. Lastly, let's cover what goes on between our ears. Some players, including myself early on, will build up anxiety because of a tough shot. Now in this case, I'm on the wrong side of the line for this eight. I need to pocket this eight and get on this nine, but I'm traveling away from the nine with a cue ball. That's okay. We can use the lay of the table and take what the table gives us to gain position. So I want to have my mind clear when I make this shot, so I want to really commit to what it is that I want to do. So in this case, I'm going to do everything like I normally do, my pre-shot routine, line it up, come around it. I'm going to then get down on the shot, and now I'm judging, do I want to draw, do I want to stun, do I want to follow? And I see this as being a follow shot. Not a stun follow, but a follow shot. I'm going to cheat it. I'm going to cheat the eight into the left side of this pocket, and I'm going to go one, two, three rails towards this nine. So let's take a look. Once again, shot line going in, come back around, cheat this eight into the left side of the pocket, and just use a little bit of top left spin and come around for the nine. Not bad, not bad. A little bit of a cut back in, but it's very doable. I'm gonna look at that cut line. I'm gonna try to pocket this nine right in the center of the pocket. Come back around. All I have to do is hit a little bit of follow, just center ball. Perfectly in the center. If you guys have any questions or comments, this is what I do. It has really helped my game. Make sure you have a smooth stroke. Make sure you use a good pre-shot routine that's repeatable, and you're going to be a better player for it. Thanks for watching, everyone. And until next time, like I always say, keep on practicing.